Parashat Shlach, the first Aliyah. The pasuk says, Shlach lecha anashim ve'yaturu et eretz kenan asher ani noten livnei Yisrael. Ish echad lemateh avotav. We start with the Parashat Shlach. We all know the main topic of the Parsha, obviously, when the Jewish people came to Moshe Rabbeinu and says, listen, we go to Israel, we trust HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but still, we want to send some spies to check, to see how the country looks like, if it's good for us, if it's not. Some says, Mefarshim, they obviously intended to go there, they just wanted to go from the north, from the south, how they're going to address. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu is telling to Moshe Rabbeinu, Shlach lecha anashim, Rashi says, lecha ledatcha, it means, yeah, you can send people, but it's going to be based on your opinion, your advice, and obviously we know later that wasn't a good decision to do it. And who were the people? So the Pasuk says, ish echad lemateh avotav. From each tribe was not the same people that we have at the beginning of Bamidbar, that we're talking about the president, the head of the tribe, talking about anashim chashuvim, as Rashi says, important people, chashuvim, from each tribe. And then the Pasuk goes, all of those people, lemateh Reuven, Shemuel, Ben Zakur, etc., Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, we go each, sorry, by the way, we didn't send Meraglim, a spy from tribe of Levi. Why? Because Levi, anyway, they don't have place in Israel to live. They had Area Levim, the cities of the Levim. So therefore, they didn't need to send no one to Israel to check the country. So therefore, we didn't have actually Meragel from tribe of Levi. So you see the Pasuk, Reuven, Shimon, Yehuda, etc. We go and each one of those names, that we're not going to open it right now, but the names was actually nicknamed according to some opinions. If Lemateh Zvulun, the name was Gadiel ben Sodi, so his name of his father wasn't really Sodi. It was just like Sod Yud, the Sod of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and the Maharal bring different kind of explanation what exactly the names refer to. Then after we receive all the names, Moshe Rabbeinu, according to Oshea Binun, Yeheshua. So we know it's very famous that because he was the student of Moshe Rabbeinu, so the Mefarshim explained that when your student is doing something that is not appropriate, it's the shame of the rabbi. So therefore, Moshe Rabbeinu, even more than the rest of the spies, he intended to call an extra name to add to Hoshea, Yehoshua, an extra letter that refers to HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yud, so Yehoshua Binun will have more power to prevent himself from being part of the Meraglim. Then Moshe Rabbeinu is telling them, you go to the country of Canaan, go from the south, go to the mountains, this is the Judah mountains next to Jerusalem, and you will see the country, it's Mahi. How's the country? How's the people? V'am ha'yoshev aleha? Echazaku, erafe, strong, powerful or not. U'me ha'aretz asher yoshev, but the country is good, it's not good. Atovai, ra'a, and the cities. Behena, b'machanim, b'mevzarim. So therefore, we see in the Pesukim that it says, U'me ha'aretz ashmena. At that time, the Pesuk says, V'hayamim yemeh bikure anavim. What exactly, it's important for us to know that at those days was Bikurei Anavim, was when the people go to the vineyard and they take the grapes. This is when the grapes start to grow. Bikurei Anavim, Bikurim is the first, the beginning of the Anavim. So the numerical value of Anavim is 172. That this is the word of Ekev. Aya Ekev Tishmon Bekoli. So the Torah gives you a hint that even when the Jewish people go to check the land, Bikurei Anavim, remember the Ekev. That this is, by the way, the same number of words that we have in the Ten Commandments. Exactly 172. That this is the name of Yaakov Avinu, Yud Akev. So therefore, the Torah already gives you the hint, maybe Kurei Anavim, that you should know that this is the time that you need to focus on what's really good and important in the country, and that's what actually happened. They were focused on the wrong things. Thank you.